Hi viewers, welcome to our electrical engineering lecture channel for most interactive sessions of different subjects of electronic and electrical engineering. For the latest updates and videos, don't forget to subscribe and click the like button.
Welcome to another video. In the previous video, we have discussed the linearity property of the LTI system. Now let us come towards the second property of LTI system, which needs to be checked in order to declare a system as LTI system, which is time invariant. To understand this property, I will show you a block diagram simply. The basic purpose or the basic theme of this property is that if you delay the input by a particular amount, if the output is delayed by the same amount, then the system will be called time invariant and vice versa. So if I have an input x of t, and if I pass through a system and I get the output y of t, if I delay the input, let's say by an amount t naught, and pass it through the same system, and if the generated output is also delayed by the same amount t naught, same delay t naught, then the system will be called time invariant. But how to check this property? To have this concept, let us consider that we have an input x of t. We will pass this input through a system. We will pass an input through the system to generate the output y of t, and then we delay this output to generate y of t minus t naught. Right? Now, this is the first result. Let us call it this one. Now, take the same input and you reverse the operation. Now you first of all delay the input by an amount, let's say t naught, and then you pass through the system. Then you pass through the system to get an output, let's say it will be y dash of t, because the input is changed. So if I change the input, the output will be definitely changed. Now we can have two cases. If this y dash of t is equal to y of t minus t naught, which is the first result, it means that the system is time invariant. And if this y prime of t is not equal to y of t minus t naught, then in this case the system will be time variant. So we have to simply check this flow in order to verify the time invariance property. Again, we can have two examples to have further understanding of this concept. So the first example is, let's say y of t is equal to x of t minus 1. Now, if you take the input as x of t, now I am going to verify it through this one, the block diagram shown above. So I will pass x of t through the system, and after passing through the system, I am getting the output, which is y of t is equal to x of t minus 1. And now I will pass it through a delay by t naught. So when I pass it through the delay t naught, the output will be x of t minus t naught minus 1. So I will introduce a delay equal to t naught. Now I have to check the second branch by reversing the order. So again, taking the input as x of t, now passing through a delay. When I delay it, so it will become x of t minus t naught, and then I will pass through the system in the reverse order. So now if I pass through the system, again we have to see the functionality of the system. Here the functionality of the system is, if you look at this particular equation, the functionality is simply that this system is introducing a unit delay in the applied input. Here the applied input is this. So the system will just introduce a unit delay in the input to result the output as x of t minus t naught minus 1. Now, if these two things are equal, as per this theory, we will say the system is time invariant. So in this particular case, they are equal. So we will say that the system is time invariant. Okay. And now we take another example. Another counterexample basically. And that counterexample is, let's say, y of t is equal to x of t square. Now, the operation that the system is applying to the input is simply squaring the input time argument. Again, in step number one, we will pass the input first through the system. And after passing through the system, I am getting y of t is equal to x of t square. Now, I will pass it through the delay. And when I pass it through the delay, it will be simply x of t square, t minus t naught whole square. So instead of t, we will be having t minus t naught. So it will be t minus t naught whole square. Now in the second step, I will be changing the order of the operation. Now I will first pass it through a delay to result in x of t minus t naught. Now I'll pass this delayed input from a system. And the purpose of this system, the operation of this system, is it is simply taking the square of the time. And in this particular example, time is only over here. So the generated output will be x of t square minus t naught. And here, you can see that these two things, here they are not equal. And since they are not equal, so it will prove that the system will be clearly time variant. So through this procedure, you can easily check if whether a system is time invariant or not. Thank you very much for listening. Hope you have got the concept.